بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله الرحمة المهداة النعمة المسداة وعلى من والاه. أعوذ بالله من شرور الأنفس ومن سيئات الأعمال، من يهدي الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. أما بعد، وأن سورة الملك I think we stopped in the ayah number 12 where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَخْشَوْنَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَيْبِ لَهُمْ مَغْفِرَةٌ وَأَجْرٌ كَبِيرٌ. يَخْشَوْنَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَيْبِ. الخشية means fear, but the word khawf, khashya, have different levels of fear. When you do khashya, you worry from something, from danger, from something that it may happen to you if you are not taken, become cautious. Therefore, none of us should do more khashya of people or fear of people more than the fear of Allah. Because تَخْشَى النَّاسُ وَاللَّهُ حَقَّ أَنْ تَخْشَى. He said, "My worried about people, but you need to worry more about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala." يَخْشَوْنَ رَبَّهُمْ وَلَا يَخْشَوْنَ أَحَدًا. They fear Allah and they don't fear anyone else. He says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَخْشَوْنَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَيْبِ. Those who fear the Lord, they worried been standing before the Lord, although they don't see Allah. يَخْشَوْنَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَيْبِ. لَهُمْ مَغْفِرَةٌ وَأَجْرٌ كَبِيرٌ. They will earn the forgiveness of Allah, مَغْفِرَةٌ. وأجر كبير, a great reward before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What are the things that lead to the khashya? Few things I'd like to mention. They create this khashya, the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a person worried for standing before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number one, it is a continuous dhikr of Allah. الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكْرَ اللَّهُ وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ وَإِذَا تُلَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا. The dhikr of Allah, the memory of Allah, make them realize the infinite power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number two, they realize their limitation. Person does not realize their limitation, they don't fear Allah. They think that their power is unlimited, infinite, they live forever. When a person realizes their limitations, when a person compares the ni'mah of Allah, the bounty of Allah, to their effort of worshiping Allah. قياس النعمة بالمنعم. That they say, how Allah bestowed bounty upon me and how much effort am I doing to thank Him. Number four is to have unshakable belief in the Day of Judgment. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلِمَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ جَنَّتَانِ. Whoever fear to stand before the Lord will give two gardens, paradise. وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ وَنَهَى النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى. A person will worry about standing before the Lord and they hold the discipline, the desires, the whims, the caprice. نَفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى فَإِنَّ الْجَنَّةَ هِيَ الْمَأْوَى. Paradise will be their abode. يَخْشَوْنَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَيْبِ. This khashya of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has to be tested in our life, in private life, not in public, especially in private life. In the issue of accountability, when a person stand alone or sit alone or lay down in their bed alone and they think about what are the things they do in their life that really shows that they don't care about Allah, they don't fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A man asks a woman to do something wrong, to commit a sin. She asked him, she said, would you burn your hand for me or your finger for me in this fire here? He said, no, I will not do that. He said, how would you like me to put my own body, my whole body, into the fire? I will not do that for any human being. يَخْشَوْنَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَيْبِ. And that's why Umar radiallahu anhu was on his dabba or animal or horse checking Medina, and he heard the man reciting Quran. The Quran, voice of the Quran came from the house, and the man was reciting actually Surah At-Tur. A'udhu billahi min shaitanir rajim, bismillahir rahmanir rahim, wat-turi wa kitabin mastur fi raqim manshur wal bayt al ma'mur wal bahr al masjur inna 'adhab rabbika la waqi', inna 'adhab rabbika la waqi'. Well, surely the punishment of your Lord will occur. فوقع عمر رضي الله عنه من على دبته. عمر felt from the back of the animal or the horse, and he for a whole 1 month has fever, a sickness. Remember the Day of Judgment. Remember the Day of Judgment. إن الذين يخشون ربهم بالغيب لهم مغفرة وأجر كبير. It's very interesting. Those who do khashya, they get maghfirah. And those who feel secure, they get punishment. And that's why they said, من خاف أمن ومن أمن خاف. من خاف أمن. Whoever fear Allah in this world will feel secure in Day of Judgment. Whoever feels secure now will get scared in Day of Judgment. Be frightened in Day of Judgment. من خاف أمن ومن أمن خاف. إن الذين يخشون ربهم بالغيب لهم مغفرة وأجر كبير وأسروا قولكم أو اجهروا به إنه عليم بذات الصدور. الله سبحانه وتعالى says, if you do خشية, يخشون ربهم بالغيب, if a person will fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in private, they fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, although they don't see him, they worship Allah as if they see him, but if they don't see him, they see them, they do ihsan, ya Abdullah ka'annaka tarah. If they do that, they will realize that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows the whispering of ourselves. وَأَسِرُّوا قَوْلَكُمْ أَوْ اِجْهَرُوا بِهِ إِنَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِذَاتِ الصُّدُورِ. In other words, Allah says, it doesn't matter if you utter it publicly or you say it whispered or you say it privately. If you say it in the group of people or you say it in a secure line, whatever it may be saying, Allah hears it. Allah hears everything human says. And that's why the comfort Allah gave to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when people were saying bad things about him, and the Rasul sallam getting feeling sad that people, you know, spreading rumors, backbiting, saying things about the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it's not true. What Allah Almighty says, فَلَا يَحْزُنْكَ إِشْ قَوْلُهُمْ. Don't let what they say about you make you feel sad. Why? إِنَّا نَعْلَمُ مَا يُسِرُّونَ وَمَا يُعْلِنُونَ. Allah, Ya Allah, Ya Allah. Allah said to Rasulullah, we know what they say publicly. There are certain things they say you don't know even about. I know about them. This is not all they say. You get to know what just a newspaper. But you never heard in the closed door discussions. You never heard what they say about you in private. You don't know they're plotting. Allah said, I know them. I know what they say. And I gave you the example of that, I think last week or 2 weeks ago. I don't know when the last time I taught the class, been traveling. Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam what a person does in sir. It's beautiful. Allah said to him, إِنَّا نَعْلُ مَا يَسِرُّونَ وَمَا يَعْلِنُونَ. Then Abu Sufyan, talking to himself, he didn't say anything verbally, sitting alone. After Rasulullah entered Mecca, Abu Sufyan, regretting that, is sitting and playing on the ground, playing on the sand, doing it like this. And what he's saying to himself, why did I do that? Why did I allow him to enter? Why I pretend to be Muslim? I should have stopped him. I should have brought this qabila, this tribe, if I have done different political strategy and military strategy, we could have avoided him entering Mecca, Fath Mecca. What did Rasulullah do? He come behind Abu Sufyan, touch him. Said, if you do what you're thinking now, still you would have not won this. At the time he's thinking it. إِنَّا نَعْلَوْ مَا يُسِرُّونَ وَمَا يُعْلِنُونَ. And that's why you need to sleep peacefully tonight. Don't worry about what people say about you. Because Allah write them down. There's a malaika write those down. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring everyone what's hidden in their chest to public, except those people who make tawbah. يَوْمَ تُبْلَى السَّرَائِرِ فَمَا لَهُ مِنْ قُوَّةٍ وَلَا نَاصِرٍ إِنَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِذَاتِ الصُّدُورِ أَسِرُّ قَوْلَكُمْ وَجَهَرُوا بِهِ. If you speak publicly or privately, if you put it in an email that said don't forward it, you say Allah knows it. Everything Allah knows. The problem is that human, they don't realize the magnitude of this power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Allah says in the Quran, وَمَا قَدْرُ اللَّهِ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ وَالْأَرْضُ جَمِيعًا قَبْضَتُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ وَالسَّمَاوَاتُ مَطْوِيَاتٌ بِيَمِينِهِ. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all glory with عَمَّا يُشْرِكُمْ. Allah says they have not given Allah the estimate he deserves. They underestimate Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا قَدْرُ اللَّهِ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ. That's why Allah said in the Quran, وَيُحَذِّرُكُمُ اللَّهُ نَفْسَهُ. Allah warned you of himself. لا إله إلا الله. إِنَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِذَاتِ الصُّدُورِ. وَأَسِرُّوا قَوْلَكُمْ أَوْ اجْهَرُوا بِهِ. Like, it doesn't matter if you say it, utter it, say it publicly, privately, Allah knows it. And that's why كان بعض العلماء يقول لمن يسره سرا. Somebody said, I want to speak to you privately. قال هذا سر بيني وبينك إلا من الله. It's only between you and I, except Allah is hearing it. Therefore, if it's something good, just say it. If it's not, just be quiet. I don't want any private talk that Allah. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punished me for it. Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Al-Mujadila, or Al-Mujadila, مَا يَكُنُ مِنْ نَجْوَى ثَلَاثٍ إِلَّا هُوَ رَابِعُهُمْ وَلَا خَمْسَةٍ إِلَّا هُوَ سَادِسُهُمْ وَلَا أَدْنَى مِنْ ذَلِكَ وَلَا أَكْثَرَ إِلَّا هُوَ مَعَهُمْ أَيْنَمَا كَانُوا ثُمَّ يُنَبِّيهُمْ بِمَا عَمِلُوا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. Allah said, أَحْصَاهُ اللَّهُ وَنَسُوهُ. أَحْصَاهُ اللَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ. You know, you worry sometimes when you go to bed tonight, sometimes you say, you know, I say so many things. And by the way, everything you say, it does not actually disappear from the waves, you know that? the people talk, this is the new science now. Everything being said, being captured somewhere in the air. It's actually remain on the air. If there's a science to collect, you can collect many people's speech just from the air. Because it stay there. The waves, those words are waves. They stay, remain on the air. The actual words. But they remain more in our books. إِنَّا كُنَّا نَسْتَنْسِخُ مَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ Allah says, whatever you have done, it been recorded and copied in the book. And therefore, I would like to advise myself and you tonight. If anyone of have backbite somebody, either to go back to them to say, forgive me, you have two options, no three options. Only three options, two options, no three. ليس لهم ثالث. If you and I backbite anyone, you have two options. You here ready for the two options? You slander somebody, backbite, say something. Whether in Arabic you said it in Urdu, you said it in Farsi, it doesn't matter. It's still words. Or an email or texting. You and I have two options. Otherwise, day of judgment will be put in the hellfire to clean the backbiting. We have to touch the hellfire. The two options are the following. Either we ask the person for forgiveness, but if calling the person gonna steal more problems, create more tension in family, the other option is to continue to make dua for them in your salah. You know, the third option is what? They take your hasanat in the day of judgment. You stand before Allah, your hajj, your umrah, everything. And Allah Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala says, this person, you wrong this person, you wrong this person, you backbite this person, you slander that person, take from his hasanat, from his salah, give it to them. Siyam, give it to the person. A person run out of hasanat, Rasulullah said, had al muflis, bankrupt. They take from their sayyat and dump it on a person, a'udhu billah. وَيُطْرَحُ فِي النَّارِ You go to hellfire. What option are we going to do tonight? You want the third option? Does anyone want the third option? A'udhu billah. No third option. You want either the first or the second. Because most of backbiting done in what? In private. Because we don't backbite people, that could be face biting. Do backbiting. We do it in the back, behind somebody. And therefore, Allah said, وَأَسِرُّوا قَوْلَكُمْ Make a choice. Whatever you say, I hear. Whatever you say, I write down. Whatever I say, been recorded. وَأَسِرُّوا قَوْلَكُمْ أَوْ اِشْهَرُوا بِهِ Speak publicly. إِنَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِذَاتِ الصُّدُورِ He knows what will happen here. And that's why, by the way, you ask yourself, what kind of heart Rasulullah has? You realize that it has? Right now. Not had. Because قال صلوا عليه فإن صلاتكم معروضة عليه. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made heart of Rasulullah free from any envies, hatred, jealousy, and only on it is love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why when he go to sleep, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never went to sleep and he heart went to sleep. قالت انام انام عيني ولا انام قلبي. My eyes go to sleep, my heart stay awake. Dhikr. Members of Allah, connecting with Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. هذا القلب لا يموت ولا ينام. Doesn't die nor go to sleep. قلب الذاكر. Why? Because the believer, a mu'min, leave this dunya, go to the next life. What Allah said about people who die for this cause, لا تحسبن الذين قتلوا في سبيل الله يش يا أخي, this is a Quran, this is not a hadith. Although hadith, I tell you, hadith also you have to follow. This is an ayah in the Quran. There's no doubt about it. لا تحسبن الذين قتلوا في سبيل الله أموات. Don't consider people who die in the cause of Allah are dead. What Allah says. بل أحياء. عند ربهم يرزقون. They're living. And they get sustenance from the Lord. عند ربهم. سبحان الله. عند ربهم. With the Lord being given provision, sustenance. Many people don't know this. I call it the infinity space of dhikr. When you enter that room, subhanAllah, you don't see the end of it. الذاكر تعلق يعني تحلق روحه في الآفاق. A person who remember Allah, the soul ascend. تعرج. That's what this is all about. Therefore Allah says, وَأَسِرُّوا قَوْلَكُمْ أَوْ اجْهَرُوا بِهِ إِنَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِذَاتِ الصُّدُورِ. This is for a vain talk being written. But how about dhikr? You're sitting in your car saying, SubhanAllah, Alhamdulillah, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar. SubhanAllah, Alhamdulillah, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar. You're sitting, people speaking vain talk, and you sit in the corner while they're talking, saying, أسر قولكم. Or you say, سبحان الله الحمد لله لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر سبحان الله والحمد لله لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر. Both. أسر قولكم أو اجهروا به. ذكر. In private or in public. Quiet. Or loud. Allah hear that.
إنه عليم بذات الصدور. قال العلماء وسروا قولكم أو اجهروا به. أريد ود علماء سيس أخفوا كلامكم أيها الناس أو أعلنوه أو أظهروه أو اخفوه. إنه عليم بذات الصدور. إنه تعالى عالم بضمائر الصدور التي يتكلم بها, فكيف بما ينطق به الإنسان أو بما نطق به الإنسان وتكلم. يعني الكلام في القلب. The speech is in the heart. إنما جعل اللسان على القلب دليل. The lisan, it is the evidence of what is in the mind, what is in the heart. إنما الكلام في الفؤاد. وجعل اللسان على الفؤاد دليلا. Every human being, their state of their speech or their words, it is in their mind and in their heart. And that's why they say, كل إناء بما فيه ينضح. A person in the last moment of their life, they want to see how they would die. The person just prayed and then passed away. What is in their heart? The person just prayed and passed away. What is in their heart? It's salah, the prayer. If they, after they prayed, they passed away, that means Allah, whatever in their heart, Allah made them to end their life with. Ya Allah. A person would die for the state for what he used to live for.
They will die for what they did. It's for sure. إِنَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِذَاتِ الصُّدُورِ أَلَا يَعْلَمُ مَنْ خَلَقَ وَهُوَ اللَّطِيفُ الْخَبِيرُ أَلَا يَعْلَمُ مَنْ خَلَقَ. Are you saying to Allah that He doesn't know the whisper of myself and yours? He said, are you questioning me that does not know, I don't know whom I create? أَلَا يَعْلَمُ مَنْ خَلَقَ. Yeah, we get offended as parents. If somebody wants to tell me what something about my child, I said, don't tell me about my child, I know my child. Don't you say that? I know my children. I know my wife. I know my husband. Yeah. You don't know them really. Because certain things children do, parents don't know. Yeah. Yes?
If you go back to the other prayer, can you explain al-sudur wal-af'idah?
Right. You asked me about the sadr, which is the chest, and the fu'ad, and azidak wal qalb. Right. The fu'ad, it is the state of emotional state. And also, it is the realization and understanding. It could be meant with it, the mind and the heart together. The fu'ad, it's a place of conscience. Allah said, مَا كَذَبَ الْفُؤَادُ مَا رَأَى. مَا كَذَبَ الْفُؤَادُ مَا رَأَى. What do you see with your eyes? Who interpret the scene? Where? The brain. ما كذب الفؤاد ما رأى. وأصبح فؤاد أم موسى إيش؟ فارغة. هي الله talk about her emotional state. When كانت تقول to me, she felt there's a vacuum. She felt something being taken away from her heart. Yeah. فكأنه خال الفؤاد مرة يقصد به the conscious, the emotional and the intellectual conscious, both of them. طيب. العقل والقلب. القلب comes from تقلب, that changes. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala attribute thought and understanding sometimes to القلوب. لهم قلوب لا يفقهون بها. They have a heart they don't understand with. Because in Islam, there is no separation between the aql and emotion in the term of submission. Somebody, the emotion is one side and their heart is one side, and their mind is one side. They are not submitting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Well, a person can be emotionally involved, but rationally, aql-wise, and not using their aql, they could be dangerous even on the worshiping Allah. Said, I'm excited to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I want to worship Him. Therefore, I'm going to pray 5 rak'ahs asr time. Asr and said, I'm going to pray 10 rak'ahs for asr. They say, no. Aql. Allah will not accept that from you. You get emotion overexcited. You have to hold your emotion with your aql. Al-aql, al-aql min al-iqal. Like iqal al-ba'ir. That which is hold the person back. Aqlahu yani, hold back. Okay. And aql in Quran used with the verb. It did not use say, لا يعقلون. He did not use the word عقل as noun. But he used the verb which is the function of the mind. يعني العقل is the rational, is supposed to hold person back. فإذا لم يفعل ذلك ثم الإنسان غير عاقل. If it doesn't do it, the person is not considered عاقل. That's why in fiqh, We say البالغ العاقل. البالغ العاقل. A person in age of property, but is what? Be able to differentiate between right and wrong, be able to hold themselves back. عكس العاقل السفيه. السفيه ليس بعقل. A person does not hold back. They not be able to control their emotion or feeling or their desire. Either they call safiha or ahmaq. Foolish or unwise. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لا تؤتوا السفهاء أموالكم. Don't give the safih your money because it does not control it. Or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, سيقول السفهاء من الناس ما ولاهم عن قبلتهم التي كانوا عليها. طيب the قلب, they discover lately the brain cells in the heart. You know that? Just Google this. The brain, the qalb, and they talk about the transplant. When they did the heart transplant, people felt something different. This is what the research is not corner street talk. Okay. Therefore, al-qulub, the heart, is something about them. And we have actually a talk here by two doctors, medical doctor, gave a talk about the heart and the new research about heart. Now, there's something important I would like to mention. In this issue of emotional, since you asked that, the emotion, the intellectual and the emotional. When people say, I'm moved by the verse of the Quran, you ask them, have you moved by it spiritually or emotionally? Because emotion is have a short life. And the spiritual have a longer life. Because you can get emotionally excited about something, and then spiritually you cannot be able to sustain it because you're not connected to al-aqiba, the consequences. You have not maintained it beyond the moment of the emotion. You have to take it to the next level and use the aql to maintain the emotion. What deals with how you maintain emotion and connection and then translate it and transform it to the spiritual state? By the aql, they remind you of that moment of that you felt. And that's why we say in the spiritual discipline, prolong the emotional state of the spiritual state. That you felt good in the haram, you felt good in the taraweeh, to try to prolong it. And to prolong it at that moment, but also to recreate the moment and re-invite the moment back to your spiritual state. Like sometimes I do remember things and it still make me cry. A spiritual moment in my life, and I'm quite sure you do the same. It makes you still, when you re-invite it back to your life, it makes you cry. I always tell the story about the man that made dhikr, dua in haram. Since that time, every time I tell the story, I have goosebumps. Because you get recreate the event in you. You know? Because we have that ability and capability. Where did that memory come from? Come from the brain. And then impacted your heart again. And that's why in Islam, there's something called tadabbur, reflection. Tadabbur happened through what? To aql. And the aql, the greater power of the mind is to imagine. You want to imagine qiyamah, what it looked like, the life to come. And you have to imagine the mercy of God in our life. To try to remember how much bounty He has in our life given us. That's why Quran said, وإن تعدوا نعمة الله لا تحصوها. He did not say don't count it, but he said you will not be able to finish it. إن تعدوا نعمة الله لا تحصوها إن الإنسان لظلوم كفار. A person should try to count their Allah blessing upon them. You will not be able to count out the blessing, but you should try it. The blessing of God, the blessing of health, ability to think, the power of intellect, all of this are power. Have you visited hospital lately? And you see people that have lost their ability to move their body? Have you visited hospital lately that people cannot eat except the tube? What is this? Life is very vulnerable. We are very vulnerable. Any minute, something can happen to you and I. Therefore, don't calculate. We should not rely in our aptitude. Today I have the power, tomorrow I don't. Sometimes when people say, I'm not religious, I don't care about religion, you ask him why. What God did he do wrong to you? What did he do wrong to you? Didn't he give you two eyes? Didn't he give two ears? Didn't he give you ability to speak? Didn't he give you the brain that to think? Didn't he create the heart that with which you love? The feeling in our heart, who put that feeling there? Who created this magnificent organ called the heart that we have feeling with it? Who did that? Therefore, we need to ask ourselves that questions, or this set of questions. My experience in counseling shows me that there's a three type of people dealing with the spiritual struggle. A person who have this spiritual struggle, they're struggling with something that they fighting, they want to feel otherwise, but they having trouble. That a person need to help, to extend hand to bring, and to help them how to do it. The second person who said, I don't want to hear it. I believe whatever I believe. جعلوا أصابعهم في آذانهم واستغشوا ثيابهم وأصروا واستكبروا استكبارا. Allah described them, قوم نوح. They put their fingers into their ears. I don't want to hear it. I don't want to hear it. جعلوا أصابعهم في آذانهم واستغشوا ثيابهم. They did like this. I don't want to see it. وأصروا واستكبروا استكبارا. They insisted in their position. They don't care. And the third person who has put themselves in a social circle or surrounding that reinforce negative behavior with them, they're struggling with the social environment. And therefore, here you ask about the heart and the mind. I want you to ask you tonight, honest assessment, self-assessment, where are we? In terms of submission, do we submit to the will of God? Or we think that we don't need God? I know you are in the masjid. You are here because you need Allah.
It's too late for that question.
What?
Too late for that question.
Too late. But ask ourselves, how certain are we in our conviction that we need God Almighty? Because sometimes we do rely on our aptitude or ability. إنه عليم بذات الصدور. ألا يعلم من خلق? Does he know who create? You know, sometimes that we don't know, we don't realize that Allah knows every one of us sitting here more than we know ourselves. It's true or not? And sometimes you try to say to Allah, that maybe I know myself better than you. استغفر الله العظيم. You don't do that. ألا يعلم من خلق وهو اللطيف الخبير. You know لطيف, one of the beautiful names. لطف اللطيف الخبير. لطيف means the one who sees the fine things. And also اللطيف is the one that holds us, help us. لطف الله. Because he knows you and I were vulnerable, he knows our vulnerability, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cover our mistakes. Can Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Almighty, with the ultimate power He has, wipe out humanity tonight? Wipe the face of the earth? Can we? Can He?
Yes.
That you, there is no headline news because all the news agency themselves is gone? لو يأخذ الله الناس بما كسبوا ما ترك على ظهرها من دابة. If Allah will help people accountable for what they do, immediately will not have anyone on the face of the earth. بس هو لطيف. الله هو اللطيف الخبير. الخبير well acquainted with everything you and I do. And you must have that belief. وهو اللطيف الخبير. ألا يعلم الخلق وهو اللطيف الخبير. والذي جعل لكم الأرض ذلولا سبحان الله وهو الذي جعل لكم الأرض ذلولا. He said something, then he said Allah is He who made this earth subservient. When do you know the earth is not is subservient? When do you know that? When do we know that we should not take it for granted, the earth? When the earthquake takes place, when it moves from on their feet, when you have the earthquake, then human beings realize, you know, we don't realize that it's, we took it for granted. The Lula. The other thing is that when the tsunami hits, when volcanoes, when have flood, when have hurricane, that all change the nature of the earth. جعلكم الأرض ذلولا فامشوا في مناكبها. Walk onto earth wherever you like to walk. Seek sustenance. فامشوا في مناكبها وكلوا. I said that on Monday. وكلوا من رزقه. See the pronoun? The pronoun says, walk onto earth, explore the earth, and eat from the sustenance of whom? From the provision of whom? From the food of whom? Of the earth? Of Allah. Why is that? Because you might plant the seed, and it will not grow. You might plant the seed, and become a tree and have fruits. Before you take the fruits, it's what? Something come and take the fruits. And that's why Allah says in the Quran, أَفَرَأَيْتُمْ مَا تَحْرُثُونَ. Do you see the earth that you sow and you work to grow things on it? أَفَرَأَيْتُمْ مَا تَحْرُثُونَ. The tiles, you know, work on the earth. أأنتم تزرعونه أم نحن الزارعون؟ لو نشاء وإيش لجعلناه حطاما. If we wish, if we will, we will make you not be able to harvest anything after it ripe on the tree. My brothers and sisters, please let me be humble. I know sometimes we become arrogant, we think that we're self-sufficient. Every single apple that you bite on, every banana that you eat, Allah made it to be to come to you. No America, no Saudi Arabia, no in Latin America, no Department of Agriculture is Allah. And the proof of that is the drought now in California. It's true or not? We pray for Allah to send the rain. He's the one who sends the rain. The Muslim pray for istisqa and Allah bring in the rain, alhamdulillah. That's what it is. وَكُلُوا مِنْ رِزْقِهِ. Eat from the provision of God. Let us humble ourselves. Arrogance, it is not a character of a decent, a believing person. Humility, humility, humility. person has to be humble. The other day, the friend of mine was telling me that somebody, you know, asked him to do something, and he said, "Oh, don't worry about it. I have done this many times. It's easy." He said, "I did not say inshallah." He was telling me, "I didn't say inshallah. I didn't say bi-idhnillah." I said, "Don't worry about it." He said, "Are you sure?" He said, "A piece of cake. I can do it in my sleep." He said, "One of the most difficult tasks ever in his life." He said, "It's become so complicated." He said, "Imam Ali, I cannot even explain to you how it become complicated." He said, "Because I thought it's just a piece of cake." Humility. Don't think that is a piece of cake all the time. One of our sheikh in Sudan, mashallah, he recites Quran in the city I grew up as if you open a recorder. He goes with no mistakes. He recited entire Ramadan, not being corrected even once. For some people said to him, "Sheikh, this is amazing. One of them said, I've been following you for a few years. You never make mistakes. You have great hafiz. And this and that." Subhanallah. Next day, he stuck in Surah Al-Asr. And he said, he took the microphone and said, "La tatruni, do not praise me anymore. It might be have get into my head. Guys, alhamdulillah. Leave this to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala." And you are not saying mashallah. Okay? Leave it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, Allah says, فَمْشُوا فِي مَنَاكِبِهَا وَكُلُّ مِنْ رِزْقِهِ وَإِلَيْهِ النُّشُورِ. Eat from the sustenance and provision, and to Allah be the resurrection. May Allah help all of us to be conscious of Him and be aware of His bounty upon us and being grateful and thankful to Him. اللهم هدينا فيمن هديت وعافينا فيمن عافيت تولينا فيمن توليت تكفينا شر ما قضيت إنك تقضي بالحق ولا يقضى عليك. Will Allah bestow the blessing upon our gathering. Will Allah grant us spouses. Offspring will be the comfort of our eyes and make us the leader of the righteous. Oh God Almighty, clean our heart from envies, from hatred, from jealousy, and fill it with your love and love of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and love to humanity. Oh Allah, make us among those who do good and encourage other people to do good. Oh Allah, make us among those who are humble themselves before you and they do not think that their aptitude, their ability of doing things, it is from them. We attribute everything to you, Allah. Oh Allah, forgive our sins and accept our dua. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا إنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. ربنا إنا نسألك يا مولانا عظيم. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم. تبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. جزاكم الله خير. السلام عليكم.
الله أكبر الله أكبر.